Hi there, I recently bought this Diamond C dump trailer. It was a special order item. I got it from Reed's Trailers in Kansas City. I ordered it on March 15th. He thought it'd be between April 10th and April 15th. I picked it up May 18th, which was just a couple days after he got it. Ordered several options. The bigger jack, the bigger toolbox. It was supposed to have drop leg jacks. It did not come with those. The dealer and I worked out a dealer. He's gonna send them to me at no cost to work that out with the manufacturer. I got the step on this side, the tarp kit was part of the bigger jack, and several other options that the dealer just got on his own. He gets on every trailer. The 7-gauge option was something I added on. Got the charcoal color, which I think is a lot sharper than a black trailer. I've used it to dump 1 3-ton load. I've had it for 6 days now. We had hail the second day. It didn't affect the trailer any. Did mess my truck up. But I'm gonna show you the good and the bad about it. We're gonna start at the front. The first bad thing is the way this jack is. You cannot get this out without either hitting that zerk or hitting the holder here. They should have put it down here, or better yet, turned the jack around, put the zerks on the backside, would have been even better. But they didn't, so I think I'm gonna just try to bend this out. Hopefully I don't mess it up too bad. It's just something, you know, shouldn't have that issue on a company that's been around this long. It does come with a really good coupler. I think it's a Kurt coupler. I have a Gen Y hitch, haven't had issues with either one. The cord here's pretty long, so you shouldn't have to worry too much about it. It's just a standard 7-way RV plug. Right here on this oversized toolbox, this is the new style. It has the, probably 3-inch sides with the grab hooks on it. On the front is your 110-volt charger. And then you got a lockable handle there. As you can see, there's huge amount of space in here. It's got a KTI pump, Continental Marine battery. And then it's just massive in here. You got two struts that hold it up, and then here you've got a 5-amp battery charger. That's another feature that the dealer I went through does. The jack comes with a 7,000 pound. This is a 10,000 pound lift, 12,000 pound static. It's bolted on if you ever have an issue. It's a drop leg spring jack. Another issue with this one was upon delivery. I don't know if you can see this, but you can see that far corner there on the left. It's bent upward, just the way they jigsaw puzzle this together. Got some nice looking welds on the front of the toolbox. It's not watertight at all. I just left the car wash. Actually, I took my first load to a customer today. I'm gonna use this commercially. But it's a really big toolbox and it'll do me real well. This is the Diamond C 24 LPD. They have the LED lights everywhere. I went ahead and got the spare tire. I just kept the 10 ply tires because by the time you pay the extra for the 14 ply, I'm gonna be more likely to get nails or other flats than I am, need that extra load rating. The gross vehicle weight rating of this is 14,900. It weighs 4,500 pounds as is with the 7-gauge Super Duty body. So these tires are rated for more than that anyway. I had asked for a step to be on this side also. They elected not to do that. It showed up without it. And that was something I had the dealer call the rep to make sure it was gonna be doable. You know, they could have put it right here behind it. I still could have had a step on this side. It would have been pretty easy. So I'll just go without a step on this side. You notice the cap back here, the one's chrome. When I got it, I didn't notice that it had a dent in it. Got it home and saw it when I got it home. So probably from forklift loading or unloading it. But I found that locally. It doesn't match, but it's Dexter brand, it'll work. Back here is where the drop leg jack should be at the bottom. Should be one on each side. I'm gonna have to cut, weld a collar on, and then I'll have the drop leg jacks. Like I say, it kind of sucks having to cut and weld on a brand new trailer. I got automotive paint. they're switching to powder coat. I think it's a terrible idea. You know, if something like that were happening with powder coat, you're just screwed. You can't do anything. Another option I got was the heavier duty bar that the ramps go on and the heavier duty ramps. And when I say heavier duty ramps, they are way heavier duty. They're the same length as the other ones, but they come with this tube on each side, whereas the other one comes with channel. And the other one on the channel, it just stops here at an angle, whereas this one gives you this nice handle, and it's pretty heavy duty. And it slides in real nice. I'm still scared I'm gonna smash my fingers, even though there is plenty of room you shouldn't. You can see the paint's already starting to get marred up on this. That's kind of a cost of doing business thing. Reflectors, LED lights all around. These chains are for dropping this down. Say you've got a, this is a 16-foot trailer, so you got an 18-foot piece of lumber you want to haul flat. You can drop that down like a tailgate of a truck. It comes with two chains, one for each side. You put them in here, and then you connect to this to tailgate while you're lifting it up. And then this is the release. There's a tube that goes all the way through, so when you pull this handle, both sides release for tailgating. The license plate bracket is in a pretty stupid spot. It's impossible to see from behind the truck, so I'm sure that'll be good. This other hole here is where you put the chain when you want to connect it, and you just put it on this bar. That's something I'm not real big on. I'm gonna try to put something around the hook on the chain so it doesn't mar that up, because other dump trailers I've seen, this just gets destroyed with that chain sliding across it even a little bit. So that's kind of a rundown of what I got. I do have some issues with it. Other than the drop leg jacks and the step not coming as ordered, there were some issues with fitment. As you can see, that's a pretty ugly weld holding this front part to the sides. And the way Diamond C does it, this side is one piece that goes all the way over, and they got about a 4 to 6 inch overlap where they go down the seam in the middle. When you look back here, can't really see in the video, but when you put a level on it, this side is a little bit lower than it is up here, like they pushed it down to weld it. And if you look from here, you can see it's about that much too short. So that side could have been better. However, that side is fantastic compared to this side, which is embarrassing. If you look down this one, sorry I'm so shaky, you can see it's actually curved in. And the reason for that is you've got a half inch where this should be lined up, and if it was, it would be true. So not only is it off here, but look at this height issue. That's over a quarter of an inch. I measured it with a ruler, and this is right at a half inch. So when you take that and you look back here, you can see the left side of this is bowed downward, and the inside of this is bowed inward. So we don't even have a true corner here. And I just think that's really sad. You know, you custom order a trailer, not only do you want all the things you order, which didn't happen, but then the fitment is something, I mean, I'm a terrible welder, but I can do that well. You know, I at least know what a corner is. You know, and maybe Diamond C will get back with me and tell me that's how it's supposed to be. I'd really like to hear what that is. I think it's just shoddy myself. Another complaint I have about this trailer is I paid for 7-gauge sides and floor. It didn't say 7-gauge two sides, not counting the front and back and floor. Well, this long sides are 7-gauge, the front and the back doors are 10-gauge. I just assumed when it said 7-gauge body and sides, it meant all four. Pretty disappointed with that. I would have paid the extra money to have 7-gauge all around. You know, I wanted 7-gauge for the strength and durability. And then the doors, which are probably your weakest link, are lighter gauge than the body, which is more solid. They do have Zerks everywhere. That's one good thing about this trailer. The fitment on this is pretty poor also. You can see somebody took a torch to cut this out. And once again, I'm terrible with the torch, and I can almost do this good, maybe even better sometimes, depending on how my day's going. Just pretty poor. And if you look in here, you can see that they didn't even take a slag hammer to it. They just left it on both sides where these little pins are. And there's welding wire in there. Just, I mean, no quality control, apparently. You know, there's some pretty ugly stuff. And then right here, welding wire is still sticking out. So whoever welded that on, weld doesn't look all bad. But come on, man, take your pliers out and pull that thing off. You know, don't just leave that. When you undo this, you can see how poorly that's cut and finished. I mean, you know, all it takes is a second with a grinder or even a file. You know, some of this stuff is pretty bad. You know, look at all the slag in there. You know, that's embarrassing. I mean, I would be embarrassed if that was my work. I'm almost embarrassed it's my trailer, you know. But it is what it is. I lost a lot of money waiting on it, and I was willing to accept that with having exactly the trailer I wanted. You know, built heavy duty, I was pretty excited about it. Churched it up to everybody, and then it comes in, and not only is it wrong, but the fit and finish is kind of crap in a lot of areas. Normally it comes with 4 D-rings. I added the other 5. My plan is, I got a little tractor business, I load the tractor in it, go to a job site, I can go get rock, dirt, whatever I need. It'll work for that. Like I said, I'm just kind of disappointed in some of the fitment issues, the quality control for sure. The paint is really good on it. Unfortunately, the paint guy should have noticed that the quality control was kind of lacking. You know, or at least told the welding crew to go back and get a chipping hammer out before he painted it. Other trailers have 2 tabs that hold it on. I think that would have been better. You know, if I thought this would fail, I wouldn't have bought it. It's just one of those things, you know, I like things overbuilt. So, go up here and we'll lift it up. And I'll show you the 12-inch on centers that I upgraded instead of the 16 that it comes with. I always like to unplug it before I raise or lower anything. The other thing, got the tarp kit came as a kit from the dealer, something he always gets. The metal on the tarp, I've put it out twice now, once with the dealer, just to make sure it worked right, and then once to show my old lady and friends when I got it home. As you can see, it's already starting to damage the paint on here. Yeah, I mean, I understand it's the price of doing business to some extent, but it could have been a little better. The steel here is pretty thin. I'd like to see if they went to the 7-gauge package. That's an option to get those in 7-gauge. I think they should just go ahead and give you the wheel wells in 7-gauge if you get the 7-gauge super block. You know, everything should be 7-gauge. I'll show you the tire steel. It shows I have a 10,400 pound capacity. And then you got your stickers here. It's made 03 of 2018, but like I say, it was delivered to the dealer, I think on May 16th or something like that. It's 4,500 pounds road clipper, owns Diamond C, 14,900 pound gross vehicle weight rating. So I say we'll lift it up. And there you can see the chains. And then here's your handle for putting the tarp up and down. So this has already dumped a load, and I took the car wash. It went up and down a couple times to rinse everything out. We're still going pretty good speed here. They use a 6-inch ram, where a lot of companies use a 5. The other company that I was looking at, the second place trailer, I looked at Low Trail, Diamond C, PJ wasn't even an option. They didn't impress me at all. Looked at several of them. Low Trail wasn't bad, but I didn't care for their pricing structure. It changes all the time. Maxed, I'm not sure if it's a division of Maxi, was my second pick.
one of the things on their trailer was the toolbox was the normal size, not this big one, but behind it they had expanded steel where you could put stuff on. Other companies put expanded steel back here where you can put tools. I think that'd be kind of cool. There you can see the 12-inch on center going all the way down. One thing that I think they could have done a little differently is on your jack here, and they're all like this, but the thing that holds it up, you know, if that were to fail, this thing's gonna come falling down. You know, you gotta get under there to grease it, which is a sign of good quality. A lot of grease works, I mean, it's gonna last a long time. But, you know, just getting under there, working and stuff, it'd be better to have this, a way to lift it up, I think, a little easier without having to reach under there to get it. But like I said, they're all like that. I do like that they have the channel with the hydraulic lines, but I think it's kind of peculiar they run it underneath like that where it looks like it could get stuck. I'm guessing if it did, it would be rectified. The 7,000 pound Dexter axles are on there. You can see the channel, or the tubing, I'm sorry, of the ramps in the brackets here. One thing I do like about this company and PJ, and I don't remember if Max D did, but I know a couple that don't, where you got your jack, you have no supports in there because that's where the jack lays. Some of them do that same thing where the ramps go in. This one puts the ramps under the support beam, so you still get that 12-inch on center. And then you can see the bottom where it's welded across. And like I said, the welds on the frame look pretty good for the most part. No, not bad. Like I said, tons of grease zerks. I love that. You know, this is where the deal comes down. I mean, it's only been up and down maybe 10 times in its life, maybe 15. And it's already rubbed the paint off of that. The frame is a little bit better welding. You can see somebody took a little deeper cut there. That's a little bit bad. You know, pretty jagged edge there. You know, down here, same thing. You know, it's just a blob here. You know, it's just fit and finish. I mean, $9,000 trailer should be finished better, I think, you know. Like I said, this just makes me mad, you know. A self-destructing jack, and all it is placement. The breakaway, the brake breakaway is powered by the battery, the main battery, so as long as you have juice there, that'll work. The chains are really nice, and what's really nice about them is if you go back, you can see that hook. They go back and they hook right there, so you don't have to worry about them dragging or hanging them over the side, you know, where they scratch your paint up and everything. Like I said, all in all, a pretty good unit. If it would have came the way I ordered it, and, you know, with another maybe hour of just prep work before it was painted, it would be incredible. But, you know, like I say, just in a lot of ways, I think it's shoddy work. I definitely won't be ordering a Diamond C trailer again. It's not to say I won't buy one. It is a much heavier duty trailer than a lot of companies. But, like I say, I can't justify spending that kind of money on something I don't know I'm going to get, you know. You look at this, it's got chips in it. You know, and like I said, that it came like that. They're painted. You know, when the chip's painted, you know it wasn't something I did. So, you know, it's one of those things, if I was going to buy a Diamond C again, instead of trusting them, I would buy it off the lot and just, you know, forgo any options you want or try another company. I've been looking at those Fleetnecks. I think they're an awesome design. Would really like to get a dual tandem with the 12,000 pound axles on it, but like I say, I'm gonna have to find one a lot somewhere, because if I'm gonna go Diamond C, it's not gonna be like that. So there you go. I plan on posting this on some forums too. Like I said, you know, that's just pathetic. I could do that, and I shouldn't be as good as the trailer builders. So there you have it. Anything else you want to see, let me know, and I'll try to make you another video.